Today we are going to be talking about the 5 worst exercises we could possibly be doing. This might come as a surprise because if you're familiar with Kaboko Fitness workouts, I always say there's no such thing as a bad workout as long as you're moving. And here I am telling us today that there are some exercises that are just the worst possible things we could do. And here's why. When we're doing exercises, especially at home exercises, it is so important for us to all understand that every exercise we do has benefits to the body, but also every exercise we do has risks that it comes with. There are some exercises that will damage our knees, give us back pain, tear the nerves in our neck, pull the muscles in our shoulders, create stress fractures in our feet, and basically make it impossible for us to exercise consistently for any reasonable amount of time. So when I'm picking exercises for us to do, it is my job as a personal trainer to pick exercises that will maximize our benefit while minimizing our risk. So if there is an exercise that is objectively beneficial or maybe really trendy, but presents a huge risk to our physical health and well-being, I'm not going to recommend doing those exercises because the risks of doing them just far outweigh any type of benefit that could possibly come from getting those types of exercises done. So those risky exercises are the ones I'm going to be putting on blast in this video. My name is Kola and you are watching Kaboko Fitness. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't done so already. Totally free for you, and it really does mean so much to me. Please keep in mind that I'm not bashing any exercises in this video. If I mention an exercise that you just love and it's working for you, please keep on doing those exercises. We're going to start this video with the 5 worst exercises to avoid, and then I'm going to show you more than 5 alternatives that are just as good, just as beneficial, but have way less risk to your physical and mental well-being. Number 1 on my list is the V-up. The V-up is an exercise that has such a special place in my heart because when I first started working out, I really truly thought that I had to do V-ups. And if I didn't do V-ups, I would never have abs. Just, it would not happen for me. I had a lot of belly fat and I was convinced that I had to do the hardest possible ab exercises in addition to the cardio exercises to get the abs that I want. And I truly thought that if I couldn't do the V-up and its evil cousins, I was somehow failing in some way. If you're not familiar, this is what a V-up looks like. There is a split V-up, which you've probably seen in a lot of exercises on the internet. There's the full V-up, and then there's also the half V-up. V-ups are actually really simple to do, but the issue is that in order to do V-ups correctly, we need a level of abdominal strength that is typically only found in gymnasts and athletes and former athletes. I've noticed that a lot of the trainers that insist that we must do V-ups and always recommend we do V-ups are people that have either had an athletic background in their past, or they've been training for 10 years or more, or they just are one of those people that will exercise for fun. On top of the crazy amount of ab strength that a person needs to have, back strength is also essential for doing a V-up correctly. And also there's the need to properly coordinate the hands, the neck, and the legs. It's a lot of moving body parts. If you're a beginner to exercise, or just coming off of an extended break from exercising, so if you've ever tried to do a V-up and you were feeling pain in your back, that's a pretty good sign that that exercise needs to be modified for your body. Exercise should challenge you, it should push you. You might even feel sore after you finish, but exercise should not cause physical pain in your body while you're doing it. Stabbing pain in the body while exercising is not normal. You know, I'm not talking about feeling a bit exhausted or extended. I'm talking about that feeling as if someone is jabbing a pencil into your back. No, that's not normal. That's a sign that your body is saying, no, no, I'm done, stop. And we need to modify this. That's what that means. Later on in this video, I will give you an awesome modification for V-ups that actually works. The second exercise I'm going to recommend we avoid is very much an unpopular opinion, but before I talk about it, I'm just gonna show you 2 exercises real quick. This is a squat and this is a jump squat. The only difference between a squat and a jump squat is the jump in the jump squat. In other words, doing a jump squat just means that you're adding a little bit of cardio to your squat. Don't get me wrong, there are benefits to doing jump squats, but if you're a beginner to exercise or have taken a long break from exercise for whatever reason, this is not an exercise that you need to do. This is not a beginner-friendly exercise. Yes! Okay, so just do normal squats followed by a boxer shuffle. If you're doing my programs on kobokofitness.com, this is not even something you need to worry about because my workouts include almost every type of squat under the sun, but jump squats is not one of them. If I do decide to include jump squats in any premium videos because I feel like the community is ready for it, at least now you know that if jump squats are not for you right now, you can just do a regular squat followed by a boxer shuffle. Let's talk about tuck jumps. If you're not familiar, this is what a tuck jump looks like. If you've been doing tuck jumps and loving it and it's working for you, not hurting you in any way, please keep doing tuck jumps. But there are a few major problems with tuck jumps that I just need to get off of my chest. The first one really is that most people just can't do them correctly. One of the biggest mistakes people make with tuck jumps is not realizing that when they land, there has to be a soft bend in the knee to cushion the impact of the force of their whole body weight jamming into the floor repeatedly. Instead of having a soft bend in the knee, a lot of people lock their knees straight and they just jump up and down like it's a pogo jump. This is just bad news for the back, bad news for any hope of being consistent in the workout routine. The second problem is that a true tuck jump means that we are jumping and touching our ankle while in the air. When most people try to do this, what ends up happening is that their knees cave in, their feet flare outward, and their back just contorts in a way that is not good for the body. This is one of the worst things a beginner can do to their body, or really anybody that hasn't worked out in a long time can do to their body. A tuck jump is an exercise that is specifically designed to train the body for explosive movement. So for us average people just trying to be healthy and fit, we do not need to do explosive movements. We just need to do movement, period. Explosive movements are for athletes like footballers, basketballers, rugby players. I'll give you some great examples of exercises that you could do in place of tuck jumps later on in this video. Next, I need to talk about good mornings. Good mornings are such an awesome exercise. They are so good, and I will look for any excuse to include them in as many workouts as possible. They can be done as a stretch in the cool down. They're really good for strengthening the lower back, which is extremely important if we're doing a lot of ab training, because if we're doing a lot of ab work without strengthening the back, we're going to end up with a muscle imbalance. It's going to pull on the back muscles and we're going to have some back pain going on, which we don't want. Good mornings are awesome for the booty. It's also really good for the back of the thigh, the hamstring muscles. But this is where a good morning starts to turn into a bad morning, because people then want to add weights to their good mornings. And this is where I personally just draw the line. The number of people that have hurt their backs trying to do weighted good mornings is mind-boggling, because there is no reason to add weight to this exercise. A lot of people will do good morning with weight the same way they would do good mornings with body weight, and it just doesn't work that way. One of the most important requirements that the body needs to meet is that the back needs to have enough flexibility to allow us to keep a neutral spine while bending forward, and also have enough leg strength to keep that lower body stable while we're hinging at the hip. And when I say hinging at the hip, I'm just saying twitching the booty back a little bit. A lot of people's bodies just don't have the flexibility, strength, and muscle memory to do all of this correctly. And it's not really anybody's fault. It's just the result of our modern lifestyle, from sitting a lot and a lot of us overemphasizing ab exercises without having an equal balance and attention on back exercises to strengthen our back. Physical ability aside, it's just not necessary to add weights to a good morning. The risks of doing that just far outweigh any kind of benefit that can come from adding weights to an awesome exercise like a good morning. Good morning, good morning, good morning to you. I have two exercises I'm going to recommend as alternatives to good mornings. And just as a general note about weights for beginners or anyone that has taken a really long break from exercise, my recommendation is to just start with body weight. And then when you have reached mastery of the body weight exercises and your body is physically ready for more, then start adding in the resistance bands, the dumbbells, the kettlebells. But until the body is ready to take on that extra physical exertion of adding in the weights, and also, we can say that we have achieved mastery with just the basic mechanics of the exercise, it's better to just leave the weights alone in the beginning. There's plenty of time to build strength, endurance, power, consistency before then adding in the weights. I know this is not the trendy, sexy, lift heavy or die trying advice that just is all over the internet these days, but it is my job to take care of you, and that's just what I'm trying to do in this video. This next one might seem like a very weird exercise to include in a Koboko Fitness video, but because it's a gym exercise, but I know that there are a lot of Coco Puffs that do my workouts at the gym. So if you're one of those that do my workouts at the gym, or you're one of those that likes to do my workouts in addition to your gym workouts, this is something that I definitely want to share with you specifically. So for those of you that like to do both gym workouts and also Koboko Fitness workouts, this one is specifically for you, because when people are doing leg extensions, they're doing it because they're trying to strengthen the front of their thighs, their quad muscles. But the real question here is why? There are hundreds of exercises that strengthen the thigh that are not the leg extension machine. First of all, with the leg extension machine, there's always that temptation to stack on as much weight as possible because we've all drank the Instagram Kool-Aid that we must lift heavy. What people don't know is that when they put a lot of weight on that leg extension machine and then extend their legs to lift that weight, what they're really doing is shredding the connective tissue in their knees, especially the ligaments and the tendons in the knee. One of my best friends actually had to have ACL surgery for their knees, and let me tell you, it's just not worth it. It's just not. We can have awesome thighs, buff knees, and never do one leg extension. Another thing to keep in mind is that leg extension machines don't even really work the back of the thigh all that much. So it's not like it's the super efficient exercise. This is just not worth it. So what exercises should we be doing in place of the ones that I have covered in this video? Let's talk about it. As a refresher, we've covered V-ups, jump squats, tuck jumps, weighted good mornings, and leg extensions. For jump squats, I already shared that the best alternative we can do is to just do squats. We can do air squats, wide squats, goblet squats, really any type of squat is good. Or we can even do boxer shuffles. And if we want to get super duper creative, we can do both. So if you have only 30 seconds, you can just do 15 seconds of squats, 15 seconds of boxer shuffles, or 20 seconds of squats, 10 seconds of boxer shuffles to get the best of both worlds without hurting your knees. The V-ups, if you really want to do something like a V-up, I would recommend instead doing a hollow hold. It's also a challenging exercise, but not quite as like killing as V-ups, but also very effective. With a hollow hold, you extend your arm and your leg, but keep your back flat on the floor. And you suck in your core and hold in that position for as long as you can. This hollow hold exercise is one that I have included very sparingly in my workouts. I think I have maybe only one or two workouts out of literally hundreds of workouts where I have put a hollow hold. And the reason is because it's just unnecessarily difficult. You can get the same effect as a hollow hold just from doing a plank. So instead of doing the V-ups, I definitely recommend either doing a hollow hold if you really need a challenge, or just doing planks. Another exercise that's a great alternative is leg drops. Any of these three exercises is highly effective to do and much better as replacements for V-ups. Side note, if you haven't done so already, make sure you visit kobokofitness.com and start your 10-day free trial. Check out my programs and see if they're right for you. When you become a member, you get access to all of my workout challenges for the whole year. It is an awesome deal. For tuck jumps, the exercise I recommend as an alternative is one that everybody loves to hate, myself included, and that is burpees. And just keep in mind again that the type of burpee you do will depend on your personal fitness level. For weighted good mornings, I actually have two recommendations. First one will not be a surprise to you. Obviously, I recommend doing good mornings without weights. That's very easy and straightforward. The other alternative I definitely recommend instead of doing weighted good mornings is sphinx pushes. You will see sphinx pushes in some of my upper body workouts and especially in my back strengthening workouts because they're amazing. Actually, I got introduced to sphinx pushes by a physical therapist many years ago. I was personally struggling with some lower back pain very early in my fitness journey. I had just started training and it was really bothering me. And thankfully, I got a good physical therapist to just explain to me some of the things that I am explaining to you in this video, which is that sometimes having weak back muscles can cause back pain, and having an imbalance between the core and the back can also cause back pain. So exercises like sphinx pushes that strengthen the back are really good and really important to do, even though it's counterintuitive. A lot of people think that if they have back pain, they should stretch the back, whereas for a lot of people, what they actually need to do is strengthen the back. So if you are looking for an alternative to strengthen the back without doing good mornings with weights, sphinx pushes is definitely a wonderful alternative. Instead of doing leg extensions, do squats. If you really hate squats because they bother your knees, do short squats. Most people can definitely do short squats because a short squat is basically mimicking the movement we do when we sit in a chair. So almost anyone that can sit in a chair can do a short squat. The bottom line here is all exercise has its own benefits, but they also come with a lot of risks. And the name of the game is to try to do exercises that minimize your risk while getting you to your goal a little bit faster. So if you take my advice in this video, it will really, really help you out. Visit kobokofitness.com to check out all my programs, my belly fat focus program, my booty program, get my app for free, all that good stuff, and I will see you in my next video.